treat bad lookers here.
Oh man,
that was, lots of bad lookers here.
That's what happens. People don't, they don't want to listen to you. I mean, the shit you told them ain't fucking rocket science either.
Yeah, I seen it a few times since then. Drunk as fuck, she's really drunk.
Hey, this shit going too.
Let's vex some spirits today.
You get, we're gonna either vex them or comfort them.
Well, I'm a Buddhist.
You're a Buddhist? Oh shit!
Hey, let's get some of that Buddhist knowledge up. I want to hear what Buddhism is about.
Just rap with us for a moment.
Yeah. Drop some of that Buddhist knowledge on us. I want to hear some Buddhist scriptures. Just quote me one.
Learning. That's the problem. Look. Learning.
There they are. There's tons of Buddhist writings.
Okay, which one? S-G-I, Zen, I-G-S, which one?
Well, you got the original teachers from Siddhartha.
No,
bust them out, bro.
You don't know Buddhism, man. Buddhism is not like it used to be, man.
Break it down. There's
no one there is old.
You know that Buddhism, that's just that.
Let's find out if you're a chicken.
That Buddha, it just sounds cool, like, man, I'm a Buddhist. You know, that sounds cool, you know what I mean?
Guarantee you have to go stay in temple for 3 years. Sounds really good.
You ever notice that some Buddha statues are dark purple, or where they'll make them blue? You ever notice that?
You're not talking about the Jolly Fat Man that doesn't
exist. Yeah, the Jolly Fat Man. Right.
Jolly Fat Man doesn't exist.
Right, well, you know, they make some of them dark purple, or blue.
Well, a lot of those, a lot of those old Buddhist statues are based on Hellenist art. From when from the Hellens came through under, well, Alexander the Great, he was a Edomite, but you know, he had a lot of Israelites in his army, and they took their images of Apollo and Athena and all that. They took that over there to the Far East. You know what I'm saying? They set up a kingdom called the Bactrian Kingdom, and they was merging Hellenistic art with Buddhism. And there goes your Buddha idol.
Here you go. This is next. Check it out. You ever read the Bible?
I like that.
You ever read the Bible?
I feel you though.
There
I'm
is
just
no
you.
Idol. There is no giant.
Well, wait. What we're trying to tell you was the Siddhartha himself was an Israelite.
Jake, you ever read the Bible though, man?
Actually, I took theology in college.
Okay.
Read that, the Quran.
Right. Okay. I'm gonna start with
Exodus. I had to.
And the Most High spake all these things, all these words, saying, "I am the Lord thy power, which have brought thee out of the land of Egypt, out of the house of bondage."
Yeah, Egypt, that's the house. Egypt represents slavery. Go ahead.
Thou shalt have no other gods before me.
Yeah, I mean, you say Buddha's not a god, but that's not the
philosophy.
It's a philosophy.
When in your life?
Buddhism.
Yeah, because they don't, see, Buddhism doesn't acknowledge the one true God. They don't recognize you, how about some of your house shot?
They don't recognize Jesus Christ.
We don't, that's, there's no Jesus.
There's a lot of teachers. There's a lot of wisdom out there. But there's nobody that's the man.
Oh, there's a man.
Philosophies.
You got somebody
that will agree to disagree.
There's the Son of Man. And he is the man.
Sounds good.
Supreme teacher on the earth, bro.
It sounds really good.
Well, quote me some Buddhist truth. Says you got to try to convince us. You know,
I don't know. I don't. That's Buddhism. I don't have to convince you of shit.
That's good. And we ain't got to convince you of nothing either.
Exactly. All I have to do.
But I just want
to
know.
What I have to do.
I just want to know what Buddhism is, because I've yet to have anybody tell me what it is.
Exactly. What is it? It's never picking up a sword. It's always being a man of peace.
How is
it's
that?
The exact same book that the Quran, it's the exact same laws that the Quran state. Because the Quran and the Bible sound, if I remember theology, right?
34.
You guys all are pretty much all the same rules apply.
No.
What?
Not even close. Get Matthew 10 and 34.
The Bible is
10. Listen, bro, you say
no. I know, which one, which Bible you guys read? King James?
Yeah.
Oh, yeah, exactly.
I got a Hebrew Bible.
You're reading an edited version that a king decided to make into law.
Bro, I got the king. Well, you got Hebrew Bibles in my book bag, bro. You read Hebrew? Well, you can read some Hebrew if you want. But nobody's going to understand it.
I got a quick scripture, man.
Go ahead.
This is Isaiah 28 and 7. But they are also heir through wine, and through strong drink, or they are out of the way. The priests and the prophets have heir through strong drink, Yep. They were swallowed up with wine.
Yeah, some of that wine, you know, that's the part of that Buddhism. That's the ways of the heathen. I mean, it sounds good.
Buddhism's not allowed to drink. Not allowed to drink, sir.
Huh?
Not allowed to drink.
Not allowed to drink.
Not allowed to drink.
That's like, that's a metaphor anyways. That's ain't talking about drinking actual wine.
Not allowed to drink.
What kind of mess up, what kind of bugged out stuff are you in, bro? You're not even allowed to drink? That sounds like,
I love a little sip of something.
That sounds like a tyranny.
Sounds like horrible.
That's spiritual tyranny, bro.
Captivity.
That's captivity. Hey, get him that one. But that's what he was reading, was a parable anyway.
Let me read this. I'm finished this. They are out of the way through strong drink.
Through strong drink.
They err in vision. They stumble in judgment. For all tables are full of vomit and filthiness, so that there is no place to eat.
Yeah, so that drink they're getting drunk on is those philosophies. That's what that's talking about. Hey, get Matthew 10:34. As you said, it's all about not picking up the sword, right? Check this out.
Matthew 10:34.
Now, this is the one they call Jesus Christ. And his real name is Yahushua. It's not Jesus Christ. Okay, Jesus Christ, that's an idol. Go ahead, read that.
Think not that I come to send peace on earth. I come not to send peace, but a sword.
So he said he didn't come to bring peace, he came to bring a sword.
No, angels aren't heroes, so yeah.
So what do you see on earth? Do you see peace or do you see war?
Well, I haven't put my hands on anybody in 25 years, so I'm pretty peaceful.
I'm worried about peace. I'm talking about the world.
I don't worry about the world.
Well, the world exists.
True.
If you don't worry about it, it'll roll you over. You get rolled over by it. So you got people that are going to roll up on you, throw you in a concentration camp. Don't worry about that. You'll be all right.
Doesn't mean we can't fight. Just means we choose not to.
Of course. Well, I mean, you're supposed to be peaceful people. But the Lord came to bring a sword, not peace. You know what's
coming? Vengeful gods scare me.
You know, but it is. But that's what you see on earth. There's nothing but the death and destruction. What happened to Charlotte
week? We make that. Wait a minute. We make death and destruction.
No, that's the Lord that made that.
We caused that.
There's
an action and a reaction.
That was the Heavenly Father that made that happen.
Hold on. So I'm supposed to listen to a God that wants me to have war and cause death and destruction.
There you go.
But you just said and verified that the King James Version was the Bible was the right thing. And
No. I said the Bible. No, the King James Version is not the Bible. That was written by a king who decided that, okay, it's okay if I sit around and I cheat on my wife. It's okay to get a divorce. That's where divorce came from.
King James never had cheated on his wife.
He was the first king to get a divorce.
No, you're thinking about Henry the Eighth.
No,
that's Henry the Eighth, and he sanctioned the Great Bible, not the King James Bible. You're mixing kings up together. King James was a devout husband to his wife, and they had many children. He was a righteous king. He never got a divorce from his wife.
Righteous. You don't rule over people. People rule over
you. Q choose King James for no reason.
Yeah.
Because he was a wicked man, you know? You got something?
I mean, we all got our faults. I'm sure he had some faults, but ain't nobody perfect.
Right.
There aren't any kings.
But when it comes to a good king, that's about as good as you're going to get.
Right. Isaiah 45:7. I form the light and create darkness. I make peace and create evil. I, the Lord, do all of these things.
So the Lord, so we're about balance. You know what I'm saying? The Lord creates peace and evil. Like the scripture, there's a time for peace, there's a time for war. You know what I mean? So there's a balance in the universe. You know, for every positive, there's a negative.
Deuteronomy's don't raise
the people ain't number vessels of Satan in the Lord, Most High. You know what I mean?
We're all puppets.
That's all it is, man. Right.
There's no free will.
Now look at this coming down the street. Not to change it off,
you know, understand. The guy is so cool.
Yeah, he's so cool.
Deuteronomy 32:39. See now that I, even I, am he, and there is no God with me. I kill and I make alive. I wound and I heal. Neither is there any that can deliver out of my hand.
Everything is being controlled.
Yeah, the Lord controls everything.
Ain't nothing get out of control in the Lord's hands. Nothing. You know? It ain't no big sad battle with Satan and the Most High either. And Satan, he prevailed to get away with the other angels.
Fallen angels and the Nephilim and the...
It's crazy, man. Everything is 1,000% in the Lord's hands.
Right? Yeah.
His control. Puppets, remote control.
So anything that exists, it exists because the Most High wanted it to be that way.
That's right.
So, like, when them riots popping off, that's the will of the Heavenly Father. When all these wars pop off, all these so-called innocent people dying, that's the will of the Father. There's a reason, a purpose behind all of that.
It's beautiful to see.
It is really beautiful.
It's beautiful, man. You know? Because he has an agenda.
Yep.
He's bringing in the kingdom. The kingdom.
And that's right around the corner.
Right. This ain't the kingdom.
Yeah, in the kingdom, there ain't going to be no war. Hey, we get that Isaiah 2. Isaiah 2 and 1.
So that just tells you those people over in Israel ain't the real Jews.
No, because they do nothing but kill. They're the main killers.
When they returned over there in Israel,
they slaughtering Palestinians.
Was that 1945? Where was it? 45.
You remember that one, our family Jew friend we have?
Yeah, yeah.
He came over, he's telling us about his uncle and how they was blowing
Vance,
up.
Lance.
Yeah, they was blowing up Palestinians for fun.
That's evil as all hell.
Yeah.
That's evil as all hell. And now they just put a bunch of indictments out on some Palestinians for Facebook. The Israelis put indictments out on a bunch of Palestinians for some of their posts on Facebook. Just in a post. They go after them.
You know, they destroyed Gaza, but...
Destroyed it.
They leveled that something.
Still is. Ain't nobody going to understand. If you see the worthless land UN, you got to wait for a month, 2-3 months before they even discuss what's going on. And when they get together, they don't make no progress. That's some bullshit. That UN ain't nothing but a puppet thing either. Also, you know, by the U.S.
They gonna make progress when they hand the internet control to the UN.
When is that coming on?
October.
October, right.
So they really gonna lock down on the internet. Then you're gonna have to have an internet user ID to identify yourself.
Yeah, that's gonna be some big changes. And I see it happening immediately, too. I hope it happens immediately. Something happens, goes and affects immediately. I hope we feel the crunch immediately, is what I'm trying to say. This is amazing. Getting close to election time. That's next month too, right?
Shit really gonna hit the fan then.
Yeah, so everything's been carefully timed.
Yeah, it's carefully.
You can see it now. Yeah. Everything's been timed perfectly, man.
Oh yeah, Charlotte just went up in flames. This whole damn country about to go up.
Who was it, Charlotte and somewhere else? That's tripping. I can't remember the place.
Not Columbus.
Not yet. You hear them preachers, man, here?
No.
I couldn't believe that, man.
What did
everybody
they say?
Stay peaceful and love it. We gotta love our enemy, you know? We gotta, oh my God, we can go on and on, man. Columbus crazy, man. Columbus is fucking crazy. Man, they gonna start killing more of these little brothers on the street, man. At a mass level. Well, that's what we're praying for, at least. Anyway.
They're gonna help clean up the community.
Yep.
They always talk about cleaning up the community.
Right.
Hey, we say fuck the community.
That's right. Let me get this out. Let me find this. Main women, people in the protest.
Hey, where'd you better read?
I found this.
Hey, get that Isaiah 2 real quick. 3 or 4. Oh, he probably ain't listening, but he got belly. Yeah, Isaiah 2:1.
Chopped up some mountain.
Isaiah 2:1.
Yes, sir.
The word that Isaiah the son of Amos saw concerning Judah and Jerusalem, and it shall come to pass.
Right, because Jerusalem is the city of peace. The city of peace. That's our capital. Is the city of peace. Go ahead.
It shall come to pass in the last days that the mountain of Yahweh's house shall be established in the top of the mountain, and shall be exalted above the hills, and all nations shall flow into it. And many people shall go and say, come ye and let us go up to the mountain of Yahweh, to the house of God of Jacob, and he will teach us his ways, and we will walk in his paths. God of Zion shall go forth the law, and the word of Yahweh shall be delivered.
Right. So that also proves that those so-called Jews living in Israel, not the real Jews. Because the scripture says when we get back in our kingdom, in our land, that all nations are going to learn the ways of the Lord from us. And those fake Jews, they're not teaching the world the ways of the Lord, are they? They refuse to proclaim the true name of the Lord. They're not teaching the laws of the Heavenly Father. They're not teaching them, you know, the proper dietary law. I mean, they have homosexual parades in Israel, gay pride parades in Israel. So how is that You know what I'm saying? How is that teaching all the nations the law? It don't make no sense.
Largest gay parade on the planet.
They just had the they just had Israel's first transsexual beauty pageant award. Did you see that?
No.
Yeah, the transsexual beauty pageant award.
I saw the transsexual couple that was married had a baby.
That's crazy. How's that even possible?
Right.
So keep going with that.
Isaiah 2:4, and he shall judge among the nations, and shall rebuke many people, and they shall beat their swords into plowshares, and their spears into pruning hooks. Nations shall not lift up sword against nation, neither shall they learn war anymore.
Right, because in the kingdom ain't gonna be no war. All right. So first, the Lord's got to bring the fire on earth. He's gonna destroy everything you see out here. All this, all these buildings y'all see out here is all going to be destroyed. All these cities, all these cars, all these people, all going to be turned into a pile of ashes.
That's right.
I was going, you know what I'm saying, just like in the days of the flood.
Oh, I'll take it. It's cold.
I need me some water. You always come with that water, boy. Is there more to it? Yeah, keep going, yeah.
O house of Jacob, come ye and let us walk in the light of the hour.
Yeah, that's what we trying to tell people to do right now. You're supposed to walk in the light. We're supposed to walk as children of light. What's that in Ephesians 5 or something? I can see if I can get a precept for that. Because most of our people, they walk in the darkness. They in gross darkness. Hey, let me get that real quick. Ephesians 5:6, let no man deceive you with vain words, for because of these things cometh the wrath of the Most High upon the children of disobedience. So if you disobedient to the laws of the Heavenly Father, the Lord gonna bring his wrath upon you. Be not ye therefore partakers with them. So you ain't supposed to be out here being friends with the world, being friends with all these wicked people, you know what I mean? Engaged in all their heathenries with them. For ye were sometimes darkness, but now are ye light. So like, let me read that again. For ye were sometimes darkness, but now ye are ye light in the Lord. Walk as children of light. So yeah, we used to be in darkness. We used to be dumb as hell. You know what I mean? But you're supposed to kill that old man. You're supposed to kill that old man you used to be, and you gotta be reborn. You know what I mean? You gotta start over. Kill that old man and be born as a new man. Papa Esau. What is going on with that, bro? He probably got Alzheimer's. He's just wandering around the city. They out looking for him right now. He gonna get on the bus and start fondling people. Yeah, start throwing shit at people.
2 Chronicles 15:13. That whosoever would not seek the Lord power of Israel shall be put to death.
Oh wow. Yeah, so I read that again.
2 Chronicles 15:13. That whosoever would not seek the Lord power of Israel should be put to death.
Right, so anybody, they ain't trying to seek the ways of the Heavenly Father. The Bible said, y'all, you're going to be put to death. They're going to be like, oh, that's the Old Testament, though. But the New Testament said that you're going to burn in that fire.
Whether small or great, whether man or woman.
Right, you think when the Lord brings that fire and he burns everything up in America, you think he going to care whether little babies get burned up or old women get burned up? No, bro. That fire is going to burn. And if you ain't one of the elect, if you wasn't selected to be chosen, you going to get burned up in that fire. You and your little children, your family, your grandma, your auntie, they all going to get burned up.
What's the scripture saying? That is the faith and the patience.
Yeah. That's the faith and the patience of the saints.
Shit.
Hell yeah.
They got a whole, their whole ideal, their whole perception of the Lord and the angels and the elect me is totally off. Totally off. Yeah, we sound like a horror movie when they listen to us, man.
That's why they come up.
Ow.
That's what turns them off.
The Lord doesn't hate nobody.
Yeah.
He loves everybody.
And they'll come up screaming at you all hateful.
Crazy motherfuckers. This is the best love we can show somebody by giving them.
Hey, let me get that for you real quick. 2 Thessalonians and 1:6. Seeing it is a righteous thing with the Most High to recompense tribulation to them that trouble you, and to you who are troubled rest with us when the Lord Yahweh Shai shall be revealed from heaven with his mighty angels. So that's talking about when the Lord comes back to the earth, he's coming out the clouds with the angels. That's the so-called UFOs. That's the chariots. And then the people, they're going to shit themselves. Their intestines are going to drop out.
Guaranteed. Hey, the toughest ones amongst them all.
Was that the heart shall fail them? Said, who shall be punished with everlasting destruction from the presence of the Lord and from the glory of his power? In that everlasting destruction, that's talking about America being destroyed. It's not talking about a mythological hell. Because when America's getting destroyed, you know, the smoke is going to ascend to the heaven forever. But, you know, still, that's a metaphor. It's not, the smoke's not actually going to ascend forever and ever. That's just the Lord telling you he's going to be completely and totally, utterly destroyed. Because, you know, they use this scripture right here to say you're going to go to hell and burn forever. That's not what it's talking about. You read in the book of Revelation, and it says the smoke, you know, of Babylon's going to ascend up to the sky forever. So how are you going to have smoke going up in the sky in the underworld? That don't even make sense. When he shall come to be glorified in his saints and to be admired in all them that believe, because our testimony among you was believed in that day. Wherefore also we pray always for you, that our power would count you worthy of this calling and fulfill all the good pleasure of his goodness in the work of faith with power, that the name of our Lord Yahweh Shai Mashiach may be glorified in you and ye in him, according to the grace of our power in the Lord Yahweh Shai Mashiach. That's what I mean. That's clear though. So all the unfaithful, they just going to be burned up. If you a Buddhist, burnt. If you a Hindu, you getting burnt. A Muslim getting burned, and you getting thrown right in the fire. That's just all there is to it. All these little fake little Christians, they getting burned up. And then we're going to rejoice too. We're going to laugh. We're going to sing songs.
We're drinking sweet wine.
We're going to have them good instruments too. Just think about the instruments the Lord's going to give us when we sing our songs.
Hey,
we ain't going to be using no regular old.
We ain't here. Some angels going to be playing for
us. Yeah, you know what I'm saying? How would the angels sing? Could you imagine that?
They don't need a microphone and speakers.
Oh, no. They knock your top off just with their voice.
That's right. That's right. That's right. Right, here you go. This is Luke 21 and 20. I'm gonna start at 20. Then let them which are in Judea flee to the mountain, and let them which are in the midst of it depart out, and let not them that are in the countries enter thereinto. For these be the days of vengeance, that all things which are written may be fulfilled. But woe unto them that are with child.
Hey, that's a good point too though. Because all things that were written, that's how we know this Bible is true. Everything you see written in the Bible has all come to pass, it all became true. Just like when the Bible prophesied of Alexander the Great, hundreds of years before he was even born. And then when Alexander the Great went to Jerusalem to conquer it, you had Israelite priests come out and say, look, we wrote about you right here, and they showed him the scripture. That's in the history book. That Alexander, the Israelites told him that he was chosen, you know, to be the head of that beast. Was that the third great beast?
But well, woe unto them that are with child, and to them that get suck in those days. For there shall be great distress in the land, and wrath upon his people, upon this people.
There is a lot of distress coming to this land. That's why y'all see these riots popping off in all these cities. But wait till the election comes. When the election comes, no matter who wins, this shit's going up in flames. It's going to be beautiful.
They're going to be going for it.
Yeah, no matter who wins, the shit's gonna hit the fan. It is country is divided. All you see is nothing but division out here. And that's the work of the Lord. The Lord is the one who brought the spirit of division out here.
I'm gonna hold that. Let's look at division.
Yeah, Luke 12. 12 and something.
Oh, here we go. Luke 12 and 51. Suppose ye that I am come to give peace on earth. I tell ye nay, but rather division. For from henceforth there shall be five in one house divided. Three against two and two against three. The father shall be divided against the son, and the son against the father. The mother against the daughter, and the daughter against the mother.
Yeah, so the Lord, he divided up the family unit, let alone the different so-called races and nations. The Lord is all about division from the top to the bottom. You know what I mean? He just divided everything against each other.
The mother-in-law against the daughter-in-law, and the daughter-in-law against her mother-in-law. Micah 7:6.
Yeah, because that's pretty much what he quoted. The Lord was always quoting the Old Testament. All through the Bible, a lot of times we'll say, as it was written. The people always try to say, you can't use the Old Testament. Well, what do you think the Lord was preaching out of? The one y'all call Jesus.
Right.
There wasn't no New Testament. He was quoting scriptures all from the Old Testament, left and right.
Micah 7:6. For the son dishonoreth the father. The daughter rises up against the mother. The
right.
daughter-in-law against her mother-in-law. A man's enemies are the men of his own house.
And you can see that. That's why all the families are broken up now. Now is a very rare thing for a child to have a mother and a father. You don't even see that at all. That's one of them old things. That's from a bygone era. That's one of them old. That's that old school thing. Having a father and a mother in the same house.
Right.
That's unheard of now. If they look at you like you crazy because you said you wanted to have a family. Like, you crazy? You know what I mean? And really, the woman is the man's number one enemy because she can call the cops on you at any time and have you locked up. And then she can just leave you. A woman can, in America, it's lawful for a woman to commit adultery on you. And then they can divorce you, leave you, get you for child support. Here it is, she committed an act of adultery, which is a sin unto death, and she can leave you and get rewarded with child support for it. If you don't pay child support, you getting locked up. That's how we know this is Satan's kingdom.
Alimony.
There ain't no alimony in this Bible. There ain't no child support, no alimony in the Bible. The Bible said if a woman leaves a man, that she gets nothing. And the children stay with the man. That's the ways of the Lord. That's why they hate the Lord.
Therefore I will look unto the Lord. I will wait for the power of my salvation. My power will hear me. Rejoice not against me, O my enemy. When I fall, I shall arise. When I sit in darkness, the Lord shall be the light unto me. I will bear the indignation of
right,
the Lord.
Right, because we sit in darkness right now. This is the only light we got is this right here. That's it. That's all you got. Well, that's a whole lot, though, actually. That's a bright light.
I hate that light.
That's that cackle.
Listen.
What is that?
A jackal.
Yeah, it's demon. A jackal. That's one of those ancient spirits of evil.
Right, right. I will bear the indignation of the Lord because I have sinned against him. Until he plead my cause and execute judgment for me, he will bring me forth to the light, and I shall behold his righteousness. And that's speaking of the Lord being that mediator between us and the Most High.
Yeah. They got a problem with that, too.
Yeah.
Why gotta have a mediator? Why gotta have a mediator?
Yeah. Well, what they say, well, motherfucker to go to court without an attorney. Have a fool for a client. A man that represents himself.
Oh, yeah.
Have a fool for a client. And that's these people, man. They don't need that mediator.
And then, what happens?
Get hung.
Yeah, right. They get hung. And that's just like the Israelites in the wilderness. They were saying that they didn't need Moses.
Yeah.
And what happened? They're like, we don't need you, Moses. So Moses like, okay. He prayed to the Most High, and the Most High opened up the ground and swallowed them up. Because Moses, he was a mediator.
And exit you judge before me, he will bring me forth to the light, and I shall behold his righteousness. Then she that is my enemy shall see it, and shame shall cover her which said unto me, where is the Lord thy power? Because that's what a lot of them say, oh, where's our destruction at? Where's our destruction at? You know, this bitch will talk this shit.
Yeah, you didn't like, that's that bullshit. Yeah, I'm talking that bullshit.
It ain't happening yet. Shame is going to cover her, just like they said. And shame shall cover her which said unto me, where is the Lord thy power? My eyes shall behold her. Now shall she be trodden down as the mire of the streets.
That's a beautiful scripture, man.
That's right.
They're going to trot it down like the mire in the street. That's the end of a hoe. You get trodden down. Just like Jezebel got trodden down.
Yeah, she got trodden. That's a perfect example. I mean, you know, it was just nothing but flesh spreading everywhere, man. It couldn't be recognized.
Then the dogs ate her, and then the Bible said the dogs ate her, then shit her out.
Spread her around, huh? In the day that the walls are to be built, in that day shall the decree be far removed. In that day also he shall come even to thee from Assyria, and from the fortified cities, and from the fortress even to the river, and from the sea to sea, and from mountain to mountain. Notwithstanding, the land shall be desolate because of them that dwell therein, for the fruit of their doings.
Yeah, so America's going to be laid desolate. That's why we said America's going to be destroyed. It's going to be destroyed by fire. From the east coast to the west coast, there ain't going to be nobody left. That's what desolate means. It means none left. Nothing.
Desolate.
Because the word desolate comes from the word solo. Solo means one, right? So you put a day in front of it, means no, not one. So that's what it means. It's going to be no, not one left here when the Lord brings that fire.
No, not one.
It's going to be laid desolate. But y'all keep thinking America's going to continue forever. Because these people actually think that this is going to keep going on like this forever and ever. Ain't never going to change. That's one thing for certain, is everything does change. You know, nothing lasts forever. What kingdom ever lasted forever in history?
I don't think none.
None. The Babylonians, then, they lasted for a couple hundred years. The Assyrians lasted a couple hundred. Everybody lasts for a couple hundred years, right? That's about it. I think the ancient Roman Empire had the longest go at it. But America is not going to last forever. You can already see it collapsing. It's just the same as the ancient Roman Empire. Just like the ancient Roman Empire, over time their money became worthless. At the beginning, Rome's money was based on gold and silver. They had gold and silver coins. And by the end, they was minting fucking bronze and copper coins.
Yeah.
You know what I mean? They took all the silver out of it.
Yeah, it's time we don't. That's,
yeah.
That's
First, the they point. Started taking the silver content out the coins. Then they just said the hell with silver altogether. That same thing happened in America. But back in the day, dimes, quarters, and nickels used to all be made out of real silver. Now they're made out of what? Nickel? A worthless metal?
Or paper?
Yeah, the money's made out of paper. So we know the collapse is coming soon. The economy is just going to totally collapse. And
the
everybody.
Alas, that great city Babylon.
Yeah, hey, let's get that. What you got?
Alas, alas.
Hey, I'll get it. I'll go hold that. I'll get it.
I got it.
Oh, you got it?
No, I can't get it. I'm trying to hold you.
No, I get it. Alas.
Alas, alas. That great city Babylon.
That's that triumphant of alas.
I love this. That's the angel scream.
All right. Which one is that? I know it's an 18, but I know it says it a couple times on it.
I'm standing out here with this hard-ass fucking concrete and shit. Man, this will be a blessing when it's in, man. I'm supposed to be off my knee for 8 to 12 weeks.
Goddamn.
8 to 12 weeks!
I'm just good.
Goddamn. It's a tear in there?
I'm gonna just get straight to the point on this.
Huh? Did I hurt it?
right now?
Hell yeah, stay hurt. My shit don't never stop hurting.
What are you doing to your
knee? That's an old injury, man. It just got aggravated because of that damn dog of mine.
Yeah, put some WD-40 on it.
Right, did not, man, you know. I'm man enough. I gotta take it. I'm man enough. Shit.
Now I actually hear people say that.
Concrete, man. Everybody feel it after standing out here, man. Whether you know it or not, you're gonna feel it. You might feel the effects tomorrow. You know?
Yeah, I bet.
Can't start hurting, you know.
It's the Esau shit, man. This is modern day Mount Seir. Or actually I was been doing a lot of research on the ancient Seir, you know, ancient Edom. And then their chief city in Edom is the where you see they got all the buildings carved into the rocks and all that down in Petra.
Right.
Because it's called Petra today. And the name of the city is Petra. Petra is Greek and means rock. But there's a scriptures in the Bible that tells you that Esau's top city was called Salah. In the Hebrew, it's called Salah, which means rock. Means the rock.
Wow.
So, and that's when the king, Uzziah, was that? He was throwing him off the cliff. You know what I mean?
Yeah, right.
And he conquered that city, and he changed the name to Jokathiel or something like that. Wow. Jokathiel. But yeah, because this right here is modern-day Petra. Our modern day Seir. This is, you know what I'm saying? This is modern day Edom. Just look at it.
I like going on Google Earth, man. You know, the map.
Oh,
know,
yeah.
Pull it up, and on the side, it gives you a history. It's bad, man, how they updated Google.
Did it? I haven't been messing with
it. History, it shows you. It goes to a bunch of fucking pictures and everything. It just shows you.
Could they be trying to say, you know, that city was built by the Nabataeans later? You know, some bullshit. I've been watching a lot of videos on it, and then they say, you know, that there's a wind erosion and water erosion all over those buildings. That has to be way older than what they're saying.
Wow.
You know what I mean?
The motherfuckers in denial.
Well, you got some people saying it was made by the Atlanteans.
What? Damn.
But you know, they was on Atlanteans. They was trying to get to the truth, bro. They just don't know about Esau. You know what I mean? But people know, but they can see that it's older than what they're being told. That's the home of Esau. And that's why all them temples look just like the Roman temples. And now we in modern day Mount Seir out here in America. Salah.
This is bad, man. It goes through a whole lot of pictures. You know, just go through a whole lot of shit, man. Man, you see a lot of that stuff, man.
You got paid for it?
With some of the view. Some of the shit.
That's pretty slick to give you history lessons while you're going on the map.
It gives you shit if you want to be a tourist, information, prices.
Oh, wow.
I mean, it just goes through everything.
Hey, that would be something to go down and visit that site, wouldn't it?
Yeah.
But you know, we probably try to get on the plane, they're going to be like, y'all, flight risks.
I wish you can't come on there, because that's an awful lot of pictures and got.
Oh, hell, it's too bright out here. I don't even got a passport. I can't go nowhere. Let me get this Revelation 18. I'm going to just start at 18 and 15. We can read it all, but that'll take all day. The merchant of these things which were made rich by her, it's talking about America, shall stand afar off for the fear of her torment, weeping and wailing, and saying, alas, alas, that great city that was clothed in fine linen and purple. But you boy, they want to be aligned like IUIC. You got these Israelites out here dressed up in purple. That's that proud color. That's the same color that the Great Babylon's decked in that whore. The whore was wearing purple that was riding on that beast. So that right there, he's telling you, showing his allegiance with the whore. You know what I mean?
That's
proud wearing purple.
Showing you he lacks faith.
Because you know, purple is the color of riches. And back in the ancient world, you had to be super rich to be able to afford them purple garments. It was expensive as hell to make. Like, super expensive.
You see the king and queen over there, man, wear purple, man. You'll see why they wear it.
Yeah.
It's a beautiful color, man.
Oh, of course, because that's the color of that's the color of luxury. And saying, alas, alas, that great city that was clothed in fine linen and purple and scarlet and decked with gold and precious stones and pearls. For in 1 hour, so great riches is come to naught. And every shipmaster and all the company and ships and sailors and as many as trade by sea stood afar off and cried when they saw the smoke of her burning, saying, what city is like unto this great city? It's talking about America.
Those port cities.
Yeah, all the port cities.
So, man, you go see a port, man. So I know back in the day, you go see a port, ain't nothing but shit.
And America's got to have more ports than any other nation.
Yeah.
I mean, you all these coastal cities, San Francisco.
It's a consuming fat bastard.
San Francisco to San Diego, all the way up and down the coast. Of, you know, Portland. I mean, all these coastal cities. The East Coast from Boston to New York. All them coastal cities, man. They just endless.
A bunch of consuming fat bastards.
Yeah, consumers. And that's why they don't even call y'all people. The elite don't even call you people. They call you consumers.
They renamed them. It's so tricky.
And they cast dust on their heads and cried weeping and wailing, saying, alas, alas, that great city wherein were made rich all that had ships in the sea by reason of her costliness. For in 1 hour is she made desolate. So yeah, so the Lord gonna make a speedy riddance. And that's the scripture too. The Lord gonna make a speedy riddance of America. When that destruction comes and them nukes start flying, it's only gonna take an hour to totally destroy this country.
Trump has been blown.
And that's what's coming, is that thermonuclear fire. And the Lord is gonna make a speedy riddance of America. What is that scripture? I'm going to get that scripture, speedy riddance.
Okay, let me finish this.
Right, let me write one more right here. Okay, there's okay. Two more, actually. What? Yeah, you got to finish this up. Rejoice over her, thou heaven, and ye holy apostles and prophets, for the Most High have avenged you on her. And a mighty angel took up a stone like a great millstone and cast it into the sea, saying, thus with violence shall that great city Babylon be thrown down and shall be found no more at all. And Babylon is America. Babylon means confusion. America is a land of great confusion. That's why you always hear reggae singers talking about Babylon. They talking about America. Yeah, they always talk about Babylon. And this is the best scripture right here. And the voice of harpers and musicians and of pipers and trumpeters shall be heard no more at all in thee, and no craftsman of whatsoever craft he be shall be found any more in thee, and the sound of a millstone shall be heard no more at all in thee. Yeah, because that's all you hear is the sound of working. Like right now, you hear that cranking and grinding back there? It's just nonstop working. That's what that mill, the grinding and the millstone is. That represents all that working and that, you know, all that labor. Ain't going to be no more labor. Ain't gonna be no more people rolling down the street and they whip bumping their garbage ass music. The Lord, every time you listen to that garbage blasphemous music, the Lord gets angry. He is not pleased by your insolent music. You know what I mean? This little garbage rap shit y'all be listening to. This shit is garbage. And there's all this other wickedness y'all listen to, all this R&B's all wicked. All the music's wicked. The rock and roll's wicked. All the music is filthiness. All they talk about is adultery and a bunch of, you know, just a bunch of heathen shit, man.
That's Amos, isn't it?
What? Music. And instruments like David and then like five, I think. Music.
No, melody. Yeah, take away the song.
Okay.
I got it. You want to read?
Yeah, go ahead.
Amos 5 and 23. Take thou away from me the noise of thy songs, for I would not hear the melody of thy vials.
That's right. I still can't get over that Beyonce song I heard. That Beyonce song, she got that song called, how's that go? When she's talking about, you need to leave your man. You need to leave him. I'm sorry. That's the most wickedest song I done ever heard. The whole song is about adultery, and she's like pretty much commanding all these young women to leave their man. And they gonna listen to her.
Because
all women, they're not very smart. And they're very easy to manipulate. Because our women are very easy to manipulate, and it's very easy to control their minds. And they do it with the music. They get up inside your mind with that music and put all them thoughts in your mind, all them thoughts of adultery. You know what I'm saying? They put all that in your mind. It causes you to commit adultery. Yeah, yeah. I'm going to be cool like Beyonce. I'm going to be just like, that's my girl, though. That's my girl. She left her man. I'm leaving my man, too. That's how they be. There ain't none of them, you know what I'm saying? They all followers.
Here's a Beyonce scripture. This is Revelation 2 and 20. Notwithstanding, I have a few things against thee, because thou sufferest that woman Jezebel, which calleth herself a prophetess, to teach and to seduce my servants to commit fornication and to eat things sacrificed unto idols. And I gave her space of repentance of her fornication, and she repented not.
Hey, that's a good scripture. That's the spirit of Jezebel. Like even what's her name? Beyonce. She everybody knows, you've seen the videos on YouTube proving that she's, you know, into witchcraft. Showing, you know, she's part of the Illuminati or whatever. Well, you know what I mean.
She don't even hide it.
But she's some low-level Illuminati.
Right, a witch, a low-level witch.
Yeah, she's a low-level witch. But I mean, that information, she's just like Jezebel. You know what I mean? That's that same spirit. That spirit of whoredom, the spirit of adultery. That's the spirit of Satan.
There's a scripture in the sin that's
I can't still, they still listen to that old beat up OG, man. Ain't her time no came and went.
Can't even sing, man. She can't even sing.
Bitch been out there singing for years. The Lord gonna put a stop to it, though.
She retired when she making all that good money.
Claiming she married a Jay-Z. You know that's a lie.
That's a joke.
That's just all fantasy land, man.
I'm right here.
What are you looking for?
It wasn't 34. It's not 34. No, it's not 34. It's not. The sin is witchcraft. But here we go right here. I'm just going to go back to the music, man. How their music's going to turn into a bunch of... Because you know where they go, where they want some approval or their comfort.
Yeah, right.
They go to them churches.
Well, who owns all the record labels?
Right.
The so-called Jew owns all the record labels. Esau, the Edomites, they control the music industry. And they only hire who they want out. They only sign who they think they can control to their label.
Yeah.
They only going to sign you to that label if they can use you to deceive the people. You think if you got it, you about to make a record, all you sing about is truth, when you singing about the Lord, you ain't going to get no record label, man. You ain't going to get no record deal. You know what I'm saying? You ain't going to have no singles. You ain't going to have no videos.
Best believe they ain't having no problem finding motherfuckers that's willing to sell out.
Hell no.
Them motherfuckers lining up to sell
you
out.
You got people, there's all kinds of stories of people getting caught killing someone because they thought they made a sacrifice so they could be part, join the Illuminati. You seen those stories where there was a rapper?
Yeah, I see them all the time.
Yeah, it happens all the time. Like some time. Young aspiring rapper kills friend.
I got it.
And bid to join the Illuminati.
First Samuel. There you go. First Samuel 15 and 23. For rebellion is as the sin of witchcraft. And
right.
Stubbornness is as iniquity and idolatry.
Right, because when you rebel against the Lord, I mean, that's pretty much witchcraft.
You know, my sister's 4 years old. She watched little kids shows, right?
Oh, that's some bugged out shit.
Yeah, I walked in and I watched it because, you know, you ever heard of Pop Up Girls?
Who?
Pop Up Girls. It's like an old show, 2004. I used to grow up watching that shit. But anyway, I walked in and it said the new one to pass. And there's like a big ass billboard that said Deport.
Really? Just nowhere, just on it.
It just says Deport. That's it. You know that show that said that dude looks at it and it says something. Glasses on and says something else, says the baby.
Yeah.
Right,
that's
right,
from
right,
they live.
Yeah, it just said equal, it's plain equal.
That's crazy.
That's why you always see in TV shows and on TV people talking about how delicious bacon is.
Programming. programming. And a child is special at a young age, man. You can tell them anything, they go with it.
Yeah, them new cartoons are they straight up sinister.
What was the name of it again? I bet you it's on YouTube, that part.
Well, even the old cartoons was bad. Bugs Bunny dressed up like a tranny. A tranny. Disney Channel is straight up witchcraft. That's pure Satan.
What kind of videos from Disney for himself?
Even my two sons, they refuse to watch Disney cartoons. They said they're fucking gay. They're not even interested in it. They watch Dragon Ball Z and fucking Pokemon.
That shit is crazy. Let me finish this. Because thou hast rejected the word of the Lord, he hath also rejected thee from being king.
That's a beautiful scripture. Yeah, because y'all want... So if you reject the Lord, I mean, good for you, because the Lord rejected you. The joke is on you.
The joke's on you, yeah.
You know what I mean?
Here we go. This is Proverbs 1.
I like the Lord's really impressed with somebody when he's the one that made him like that. You know what I mean?
Right, he ain't losing a thought.
Yeah, right, like... like, they you know... Because people act like they got a victory when they like, fuck that bullshit, that's some bullshit y'all talking about. And they feel all victorious. You know what I mean? Okay.
With Proverbs 1 and 23. Turn you at my reproof. Behold, I will pour out my spirit unto you. I will make known my words unto you. Because I have called, and ye refused. I have stretched out my hand, and no man regarded.
Right, because the Lord stretched his hand out right now through his prophets. Okay.
Whether you like the prophets or not, the Lord chose.
Right, why do you think they have prophets in the old school? You had the, who was that? The prophet Nathan that went to King David and told King David that he had sinned. He went to King David himself and told him that he sinned. Mm-hmm. You know what I mean? So the Lord set up prophets.
But ye have set at naught. I hate that loud shit.
Yeah, it sounds like.
I hate it, man. And that's coming to an end too, all that matters, man.
It sounds like witchcraft, just like that scripture says. When you disobey the ways of the Lord, that's like witchcraft. You got that spirit of Satan on you, got on them demons on you.
But ye have set at naught all my counsel, and would none of my reproof.
Yeah, because you know, most of our people, they don't want none of the proof of the Lord. They don't want no counsel of the Lord. They gonna go get their counsel from their rap music. And I heard people say too, my music is like my therapy. You know, like, what kind of therapy is that? That bullshit y'all listening to. All they talk about is robbing, stealing, I fucked your bitch, I'm cooking these cakes. You know what I'm saying? All it's talking about is a bunch of grimy ass fucking shit. Just killing and stealing and robbing, selling drugs, adultery. That's all the music our people listen to.
I don't know if y'all ever experienced it, man. Have the song in your hand and build it out in your head. It goes to your head the whole night.
Yeah.
The next day for a few days.
It's just, yeah.
That's a awful feeling.
That's an awful feeling. Because that's a spell, though.
Yeah.
That's a magical spell. Y'all understand that the people making that music, they're like witches and warlocks. And they use that music to put a spell on you and to control your ass. And you can see it when they being in that trance. They listen to that music, they get in a trance, they'll just start gyrating out of nowhere. They just get bugged out. You see Jay walking down the street rapping, shooting finger guns. You know what I mean? Yeah, just looking dumb as hell. And then everybody driving out looking at shaking their head like, what the fuck,
everybody.
What the fuck is wrong with this motherfucker right here? And they got demons on them. That's that demon just stirring your ass up. And then the women is the worst. They'll start shaking their ass and gyrating like a cat. Like a cat. They'll start rubbing up against telephone poles and everything. You know what I mean?
That's crazy. And that really happens, man.
I see it every day.
Yeah, every day. You're not even exaggerating.
It'd be all silent. Nobody say anything. They come out of nowhere and start rapping and shit.
Yeah.
I thought he'd say something, but he's over rapping.
Yeah, you think someone talking, they over there freestyling.
Out of nowhere, though.
All tied up. This shit is young. He got his little brother shit on. I also will laugh at your calamity. I will mock when your fear comes.
Right, so when the Lord brings that fear and that calamity, the Lord gonna mock you, man. That's just like Psalms. What is it? Is that Psalms 2 or is the first chapter? When the Lord say going, is that where you at, Psalms?
I mean, Proverbs.
Oh, Proverbs. Yeah. Oh, yeah. That's Proverbs. But you know the Psalms that says the Lord's gonna last. Hey, right, that's yeah. He's just hanging, just kicking it.
Wow. I will laugh at your calamity. I will mock when your fear cometh. When your fear cometh as desolation.
There go that word desolation again.
That's right.
That's a popular word, desolation. Why does the Lord keep speaking of desolation? Because this place is going to be laid desolate.
Wasteland.
Yeah, it's going to be a wasteland. And it's going to be, yeah. You see the movies, what is that movie, the Mad Max movies?
Ooh, wee.
That's your boy right there. He ain't fucking around.
That's a hell of a character right there, boy.
Check out that boy's hat, bro. You gotta give him points for originality.
That's a, hat,
that's a nice hat.
Yeah, original.
At least he came with his own style, bro.
And your destruction cometh as a whirlwind. When distress and anguish cometh upon you, then shall they call upon me, but I will not answer.
And that's how our people always do it. Every time we teach, you know, our people love to come against the words of the Lord. But as soon as something bad goes down, they,
oh Lord Jesus, please save me.
Every time, it never fails.
Even when they believe in other gods, but they still go back to that Jesus.
Oh, they still go there. They have the Bible out.
Well, you got the one dude over there, got the purple rose on and red rose over there.
Never fails.
No. They come out, like you go over there and tell them, they said, ain't no God for us.
Woo!
No, they said their God, the real God, got the woolen beard. I said, man, and they tell me, they told me, they said, you're not a brother, you're a white man.
Out here, they said
you was a white man.
Why they called you a white man?
That's crazy as hell.
But they ain't give you a reason why they called you a white man.
They sick, man.
Called you light-skinned or something, or what?
Yeah, because my grandmother's Italian. My daddy darker than any man.
They might be Jakes, too.
Yeah, oh, yeah,
you
Italians.
Know, them Italians, right.
Yeah, Italians is black,
yeah,
too.
My granddad, my grandma, my mother.
That's
man,
all right, bro.
Jake, man. You wanted
the Lord got them guys over there covered. You know what I mean? Because they got it covered.
You know, I can wait on this over there.
We know those guys.
And all of the children of Jacob had a body in the heaven, which be a gift of the children that were born.
Well, yeah, the Lord's people is the children of Jacob. We're the children of Jacob. The Lord's children.
And each of the 12 of the children have a sign in the heavens, a moon, a planet.
Oh, that could be true.
Put there by God for their birthright.
Yeah, because all that zodiac and all that stuff is based on Israel. They all came from Israel.
I'm from Judah, Benjamin, and Levi.
You from Judah, Benjamin, and Levi?
Yeah. For real?
They from three tribes, boy.
How you do that? How you do that?
My mom's a Rosen. Jesus' little brother, Joseph's Rosen. Grandfather, my grandfather on her side, Joseph Rosen. The risen. What was left of his brother?
He a Jacob.
Stallone.
He a Jacob. You a Jacob.
Stallone. John Donovan.
But look, read the sign. Read the sign.
I think we need to repair that sign.
Joe G's gonna go back over with Black
Mountain.
Yeah. Yeah.
Got off the see, you see Judah? Judah? You see?
Wow, that was good.
See Benjamin?
Western.
Jamaicans. Came down. Levi. Haitian. You were here somewhere.
You have any Italian?
They're Italian, some of them Italian. Most Italians are Jake. Most of them Italians are.
To be honest with you, we can't even fit all of Israel on that side. We need a sign.
I'm Italian, Joseph Gianpietro. My mom's first Jamaican name. Joseph Adams.
Those are all Hebrew names. Joseph, Giovanni.
Leon Vito. Joseph from my grandfather, Abraham, that first one ever.
What about your father?
Adam, the first earthly father born on earth.
Okay, my man.
And John Vito, Jesus, faithful martyr. You have met him.
All right, brother.
Yep. He didn't have no, you know what I mean? Like, he didn't have no scoffing in his mouth. He just in the spirit.
They just.
Israel, that's Israel, man.
He just gone, though.
Yeah, ain't no need to cut him.
Nah, he can't. Just
ain't
let
no
it go.
Need, man.
When they come up, like, you just got to let them go.
Yep, that's it. That's it. You know?
That boy said he was from three tribes.
Yeah. Oh, but dude, man,
that was crazy, though. He was clearly a... Why would you even calling that guy a white dude? That didn't make no sense.
They bugged out, man. Scattering the flock, scattering the sheep, man. What some evil motherfuckers, man.
They got blood on their hands. And every week,
man.
So look, the camera's getting it, bro. Every week, people come out here and they say those goddamn purple guys.
Never fails. That's beautiful, man.
And it's not like, because you know the scriptures say, you know, the true men of the Lord, nobody likes the true men of the Lord. But IUIC, the reason people don't like them ain't because they're teaching the truth. It's because everybody sees that they're full of shit.
Yeah, this is the man right there.
Yeah, I think so.
You see what I'm talking about?
Yeah.
Right there, purple dancing.
Oh, God. You know, everybody sees that something ain't right about IUIC, though.
Oh, yeah, everyone there, man.
That's fucking scary. That's
Make a sweet love. Oh, wait, you know what? I was looking at the pictures of the new Satan temples they're throwing up.
Yeah.
Oh, man, they got a motherfucking statue of somebody eating out Baphomet.
Oh, shit.
Eating his ass out. It's a statue. The dude eating him out.
But they gonna put that in public. Hey, there was some school up in California. Ooh. Where was that? Was it San Francisco? Oh, I can't remember. It was somewhere on the West Coast. It was just in the news last week that the city voted on it or whatever, and they said that the public school has to allow the Satan after school program. They got an actual satanic after school program, and the school said, well, we have to be inclusive and allow, if the Christians get a group, we got to let the Satans get a group.
And the mayor said, I'm the mayor and I'm a Christian and I think it's a beautiful thing.
That's whacked in the fuck. I'm like, you know what a fucking devil worshiper is? That's bugged out.
Hey, we in Babylon.
That's crazy as hell.
Yeah.
And people will come up and argue. You're right. They have the right just as you have the right.
There ain't no Bible teaching.
Like, they're fucking, they worship Satan.
I don't see no Bible teaching after school.
Like, you know what Satan worshipers do. Mm-hmm. We shouldn't have to explain that to somebody.
Yeah. Satan worshipers. A whole lot of people come before us on why they're curious.
Yeah, Satan.
Just restart their curiosity.
And then you have the Satanists. They'll try to say, well, we just use the word Satan as a metaphor for being anti-religion. And you know, people, that's that top layer, introductory level Satanism. And they'll tell you, say, we don't really worship Satan. That's just, but you gotta understand that Satanists, his job is to lie. Everything is a lie. Okay? And you ain't gonna move up in the ranks unless you see through to their lies and you lie.
That's right.
You know what I mean? Because your boy, the founder of the temple, the Church of Satan, Anton LaVey, he was always holding rites and doing rituals and putting hexes on people. I watched the interviews when he said he put a hex on somebody. You know what I mean? He said he had, you can watch the interviews on YouTube, man. They're all over the place. And he actually worshiped Satan. It was not a fucking metaphor.
Here you go. Nahum 3:4. Because of the multiple of thy whoredoms and well-favored harlots, the mystery. Let me start at one.
Yeah, who's a well-favored harlot?
I'm gonna start at one, man. I'm gonna start up.
America's a well-favored harlot.
Right. I'm gonna get back down there. I'm gonna start back at one. Nahum 3:1. Woe to the bloody city. It is all full of lies and robbery.
Now, right. That's what America is all full of lies. And everything you see is a lie. Everything you see on the news is a lie. They lie about everything from 9/11 to Sandy Hook, all the, you know, the shootings, Boston bombing, Oklahoma City. You name it, bro. They lied about weapons of mass destruction in Iraq. Well, we could go on all day. They lied. They said they killed Obama. They killed Osama bin Laden. They killed, and then they threw his body in the ocean. Like, oh, we killed him, but we can't show you the body though, cause we threw it in the ocean. And then y'all believed it. I read that again.
Woe to the bloody city! It is full of lies and robbery. The prey departed not.
They full of rob. What does America do? All they do is go around the world just robbing everybody. And then they rob their own people right here. Here it is. You working 40 plus hours a week. You know, breaking your back, you get no free time. You just constantly laboring, constantly just working. And then before you even get your check, half of it's missing. They done took it out in taxes. Now, you know, the Bible says if you pay tithes to the priest, you're supposed to give, what, a 10%? But in America, they make you pay, what, like 40%? And that's another way, you know, Donald Trump, they say, oh, he's a great Christian, man. He's a Bible believer. But he was talking about taxing people on what? He said like 14%.
Dang.
He was still going over the biblical limit. We'll show you he ain't got no truth.
You see, y'all hear the speech with what's the boxing promoter back in the day?
Don King. He said, you need to learn how to be like a white man.
Yeah.
That's what he said.
The people behind him was cracking up.
Yeah. That Don King is crazy as hell.
He called these motherfuckers niggas too.
He did he?
Yeah, he called them niggas.
And he was a murderer, wasn't he? Didn't he murder somebody?
He mentioned that. He mentioned being put in prison and all this next.
He actually killed somebody. He's an actual murderer.
Yeah, Don King.
And what's he famous for? He said you need to be like a white man. He's famous for ripping off all those boxers. He got all Mike Tyson's money. Anybody who fought for Don King got ripped off. That's why,
all of them. Yeah.
That's why you see, don't Floyd handles all of his own business, don't he?
The noise of the whip of a whip and the noise of the rattling of the wheels and the prancing horses and of the jumping chariots. The horsemen lifted up both the bright sword and the glittering spear, and there is a multitude of slain and a great number of carcasses, and there is none end of their corpse. They stumble upon their corpse because of the multitude of the whoredoms of the well-favored harlot, the mistress of witchcrafts, that selleth nations through her whoredoms and families through her witchcrafts. Behold, I am against thee. I am against thee, saith the Lord of hosts. And I will discover thy skirts upon thy face, and I will show the nations thy nakedness and the kingdoms thy shame.
And you've seen that nakedness right now. What's that scripture? To lift up the skirt, make the leg bare?
Yeah,
read that one last part again, though. Yeah.
Okay. Because of the multitude of the whoredoms of the well-favored harlot, the mistress of witchcrafts, that selleth nations through her whoredoms and families through her witchcrafts.
Ain't that America? What else would that be describing?
The process of elimination. Only America fits that.
That means it's a nation founded on witchcraft. They got Satan after school programs. What other country they got Satan after school programs?
Where now? I'm smoking this one.
And then Bibles, they got Satan after school programs. No Bibles allowed in school.
Shit.
Hey,
trouble.
Three packs for $10.
They
give me three packs for $10.
Damn.
It came up, son.
Can't beat that. Can't beat that.
That's quick way to learn a disease.
Can't beat that quick way to learn a disease. Only quicker way is to find them, motherfuckers. Behold, I am against thee, saith the Lord of hosts, and I will discover thy skirts upon thy face, and I will show the nations thy nakedness and the kingdoms thy shame, and I will cast abominations up, and I will cast abominable filth upon thee, and make thee a vile, and will set thee as a gazing stock.
Yeah, so that says the same thing as Revelation, don't it?
Yep.
how, you know, Revelation said all the merchants, and everybody weeped, and when they decided the destruction, you know, the other heathen, you know, Ishmael gonna be weeping, bro. All them Saudis done made all that money off selling all that oil and everything to America. They gonna be sad. And then they gonna go right into slavery. Yeah, all them heathen countries, they gonna weep, bro. The only ones gonna be we're gonna be rejoicing.
Go ahead. Isaiah 10, the 1. Woe unto them that decree unrighteousness decrees, and that right grievousness which they have prescribed.
Right, all these laws in America, these are unrighteous decrees. Yeah, all these, you got, there's like millions of laws in America, but it's still legal for a woman to commit adultery. They can kill their own baby. They give it a fancy word like abortion. You know what I mean? Oh, that's legal. You're allowed to murder. You're allowed to commit adultery. You're allowed to be a faggot. Okay.
So it's pro-choice.
But they won't follow none of the laws of the Bible. And they'll lock you up if you don't pay child support. That's an unrighteous decree.
Pay your taxes, they lock you up for that.
Yeah, don't pay your taxes. You go straight to jail. Well,
they about to lock stuff. Hey, wait a minute. That was in Texas where they locked that motherfucker up for having a past due credit card bill. No, his school loan. Came and got due for a school loan to lock you up. Yeah, so it's just gonna spread. That's just gonna spread. No, what's the other word for it? Draconian measures.
Yeah, that's draconian.
Draconian.
Actually, back in ancient Greece, there was an actual god named Draco.
Draco.
And he was a in that ancient Greek, and he. That's where that word comes from.
Draco.
But he must have been like a dragon-like spirit. Gnomon, omen. You know what I mean? But yeah, he was pretty much a tyrant.